Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator 2021. Today, we're going to be taking a loaded oil train from just south of Caldicot up to Morgan, where another driver will relieve us from this service. As you know, this is one of my work in progress, super hard scenarios. And without further ado, let's get started. Just to let you know as well, folks, this scenario is very much work in progress, and this is among the final testing. So the next thing for me to do before I release this scenario to the public will be to proofread all the descriptions and stuff, just to make sure that all the spelling and grammar is correct, or at least my ability anyways, as there is no auto spell checker on this. And I do like my scenarios to look professional, but as expected really, this scenario will involve lots of stops, low speed maneuvers, and many other activities that involves driving a heavy freight train in heavy rain and being a low priority service. All passenger and higher speed freight trains will have priority over this service anyways, so this should make for a fun and a challenging scenario, but this is an ultra hard one and it won't be one of the easiest ones to complete anyways. But we are due to arrive at 11:08, approximately at our first checkpoint on this scenario, okay? Anyways, as you can probably expect, folks, I'm using the Armstrong Powerhouse Weather Enhancement Pack, of which I'm using the Heavy Rain. I'm still trying to work out how to add the lightning bolts into the scenario. So if there is any tutorials, or if anyone has any advice on how I can put these in the game and to make the lightning look realistic, I do plan to do that in a future scenario, and I would appreciate any advice. I'm not afraid to mess around with the assets that comes with this weather enhancement pack. However, if I am successful, I will have a go at doing a tutorial or something, just so those of you that want to add more in-depth weather and stuff into your scenarios can do so. Anyways, I will have, once I've done enough recordings and Let's Play videos just to keep the channel going, I will do some experimentations just to make sure that we're doing it right. Anyways, I'm going to let you enjoy this video, and I will chat to you once we get to the first checkpoint, okay? As you can probably tell from the auto sander turning on and off, and as you can probably see from the weather, the brakes are very sluggish on this train as the rails are quite slippery. And we do have 3,200 tons of oil on the back of this train. And our train today is 6015 in the DB Schenker livery. And this comes as a mega pack of reskins for the Just Trains Class 60, which is from BH Reskins. And it does enhance the default textures to make them look more realistic than just the wrong shades of red and stuff. And personally, as a Class 60 fan, I'd definitely recommend getting this bike, as it will be a requirement for this scenario anyways. But I will provide a full comprehensive list of everything you need if you wish to have a go at doing this challenge yourself. As you can just see in amongst the rain up ahead, we are getting closer to our signal, which is showing danger. So I'm just going to ease off the power, and I'm just going to apply a wee bit of braking just to bring us down. As you know, we do have the wheel slip indicator there, folks. So this train is going to take a lot longer to slow down than what it would in dry conditions. And that's what I like about this weather enhancement pack, as well as the physics, as I'm using the Armstrong Powerhouse Class 60 sounds as well. And it does add more to the immersion and the realism of playing this game. We do have another train to pass us, folks, so we'll just have to wait here for a wee while until the line clears, and then we can proceed once the line clears. As you know, I'm still doing some testing just to make sure everything on this scenario is working as it should be, and this is very much a beta test. Anyways, I'm just going to acknowledge this message and we'll continue to wait here until the signal changes. So I just must remember to put the reverser into neutral. Although there is no working driver reminder appliance on this train, we have got a caution, so we can now carry on as normal under cautionary speeds, just in case we have to stop at the next signal. We are still doing 15 miles maximum speed limit, as we're not yet out of the Caldecott down loop, so we are coming up to another cautionary signal and a lower speed limit of 40 miles an hour, so we do have a lot of hazards to keep our eyes open for. So once this AWS alarm goes off again, I will just acknowledge that and prepare my train to slow down for another upcoming speed limit of 15 miles an hour, as we will be going via the freight loop, folks. And as you can see here, we do have a southbound GWR HST just passing us on the right there. We have just passed the signal of caution, folks, so I'm just being prepared to, in case I have to stop the train if the next signal is a danger, of which normally comes after a single yellow. As you know, for those of you that may not be aware of the UK rail signalling, we use block signalling, which is usually green for clear, double yellow for caution on four aspect signals, single caution, and then red for stop. I'm going to continue to build up a speed up to no more than 30 miles an hour. The reasons being is that in case I need to slow down or stop at the next signal, I'm assuming it's not changed until I get a visual. I can then prepare well in advance, and that will avoid causing a spad, which means signal past a danger, as I do like to drive properly when I do these let's plays, you know. As you can see there, folks, we do have a clear line, so I'm just continuing to build a speed to go up to the maximum of 40 miles per hour. However, we will be coming off the branch line soon and onto the freight lines, and that will be the maximum permitted speed limit of 15 miles per hour, of which will be for approximately a mile or so. So this will be a hard or an out for a hard scenario, as it does involve a lot of low speeds and waiting for passenger trains to pass and stuff. But anyways, we're approaching 40 miles per hour, so I'm just going to get ready to level off. But I will do it after this turn, as we are going slightly uphill, and with 3,200 tons of fuel on board, it is quite easy to lose speed. But anyways, I'm going to idle the power now, and I'm going to get ready to slow down, as we have an upcoming speed limit reduction to 15 miles per hour, as we will then go on to the freight only lines. I'm still decreasing my speed, folks, but as you know, this is a very heavy train, very slippery rails, and it does take a lot longer to bring the speed down. But we are in the 15 miles per hour zone now, and this is the freight only line that goes around the back of the branch line. And I do plan to do some scenarios for other freight and diversions as well, as I do like to make freight scenarios as well as passenger ones, as I tend to find the freight ones quite fun to do. And we do have the class 70 that is coming on our right here that will be passing us shortly. And just another thing to point out as well, folks, the wagons to the right that are being hauled by the Class 70, these are also available from Armstrong Powerhouse, as with the tankers behind this Class 60, of which I'll just take a brief moment to show you. I just increased our power there just momentarily, just to level off our speed at exactly 15 miles per hour. And I'll do this momentarily just to get us through this reduced speed zone as quick as we can. But as you know, we will have to wait for passenger trains and stuff, you know, as this is quite an intense scenario that I'm creating. Thank you. I know this is a bit of a long drag, folks, but things will improve once we clear this checkpoint, as we will be joining the branch line again soon, and we are coming up to a red signal that is just around this corner here. So I'm just bringing the speed down to about 8 miles per hour, just so that I can see the signal and take appropriate action so that I can stop in time, as the last thing I want to happen is for this signal to be passed at danger. And as you can see there, folks, through the rain, the signal is showing a red, and I'm just getting an AWS warning alarm going off there that I've just acknowledged. So I'm just going to release the brakes and then just gently coast closer to the signal and then apply the brakes again, which will be quite early. As you know, this train does take a lot longer to stop, so just keep this in mind if you decide to play the scenario for yourself, okay? As it will be very easy to run a red if you're not too careful on this scenario, as this train is very heavy and it does take a very long time to come to a complete stop. That invisible train, folks, would be a GWR-HST. Sometimes it loads, sometimes it doesn't. As when I was testing this scenario earlier, it was actually working better, and it was showing up. So I may have to clear the cache again, just to make sure that these show up properly. That's a HST bound for Cardiff. We are just waiting for a local passenger service to clear the line, and once that's done, we should get the road to Usk up branch that will be our next checkpoint for this service. just to inform you folks, that was the double class 150/2. That would be a first Great Western and GWR train, although it didn't show up again for some reason, although it did in the last test that I did before this video. Anyways, we now have a caution signal, so what I'm going to do, we can now prepare the train to go. So I'm just going to have to apply and take off the power, otherwise we're not going to be able to move. That signal has now changed to green, so I'm just going to increase the power to about 55%, as I should get this heavy train moving. And we do have an upcoming speed limit increase to 60 miles an hour. However, we won't be achieving that, as the next checkpoint will be 10 miles per hour. So until we get to Cardiff, we do have a lot of restricted speed limits. As you know, I do like to make several scenarios of various difficulties, just to give someone a challenge, including myself. Right, folks, we are coming up to our next checkpoint here, and we do have a reduced speed limit of 10 miles per hour, so this should be the last checkpoint before we reach Cardiff, as then we may be held there whilst we wait for some passenger trains, but this one will be the last low speed checkpoint before Cardiff. Just to acknowledge that AWS there, and preparing to slow my train down, as we will have to wait for another local passenger service. Anyway, folks, just a wee question for you. What's your feedback so far on this scenario, let's play that I'm covering? Are these the kind of scenarios that you'd like to do? Or would you like to do something a bit different? As I'm looking for suggestions and ideas, as long as I have the suitable rolling stock and stuff, doing the scenarios and releasing them shouldn't be a bother. As you know, I like to cover various scenarios of freight, passenger, and all the other kinds of stuff. But anyways, we've got an HST just passing us. There's the Arriva Cross Country Trains version. At least that one's showing up, which is grand. As I'm using Arriva Cross Country, First Great Western, and GWR, as this scenario is based in 2017. From how I remember the railways. But anyway, folks, we are coming into our checkpoint, and I will stop the train once we are clear of the branch line, and I'm going to try and pull up to the signal. So I'm running at about 8 miles an hour, as I don't want to run this red, especially as these rails are very slippery. But anyways, please do leave me your feedback and suggestions, as I'm always looking for new ideas and suggestions for new content in terms of making scenarios for Train Simulator, and of course Train Simulator Let's Plays as well. As the local passenger train has just overtaken us, we should get the road soon. If there's no other trains coming. So hopefully not too long to wait now. As you can see there, folks, we did slip backwards, of which, due to the slippery rails, and I think a bug with the Class 60 itself, the train did slip backwards, but I did get the train back under control using manual sand application. So just use a sander if you need to, okay? Once the train gets a grip, it should move fairly straight forwards. Just some advice here, folks. I know I'm breaking the speed limit and I'm still in the 10 mile per hour zone from the siding, but if I try to drive to 10 miles per hour, I will lose grip of the train again, and I don't want it to roll backwards, especially now that I have it now in full momentum. So if you need to break the speed limit just to get the train going, feel free to do so. I won't worry too much about it in terms of train simulator, as to be honest, the physics on this Class 60 are not that realistic anyways. Not compared to the real life Class 60s. But anyways, we're now getting up to speed, as we're now back in the 40 mile per hour zone. And our next checkpoint will be Cardiff, where we will have to wait for some passenger services. But anyways, we have a checkpoint at Newport, but we're not due to stop for any trains, and we do have a clear signal up ahead too. But as always, I do appreciate your feedback on this scenario that I am creating, as well as your suggestions and requests as well, as I will be making many scenarios this year, that's for certain. This is just a bug with a train, folks. It will right itself, so I've just left the power on full, and it will correct itself once it's done. Once it's done messing about, To be truthfully honest, folks, this is not me doing the power up and down and making this train jump like a kangaroo. This is actually a bug with the class 60 physics. As you can see there, it does say wheel slip, but I have the sander turned on, as I've not turned it off yet, but I will do now. But I'm going to keep the power fully applied until it stops jolting backwards and forwards. When that'll be, I have no idea. But it is a bug with a train. Finally got there in the end, folks. Now that this class 60 has got over its kangaroo moment, we should be able to pick up a bit of speed as we get closer to our next checkpoint that will be at Cardiff. As you can see there, folks, I do have the power on 100%, and I do have the sander on manual, just so that the train can grip the rails without the wheel slip keep cutting the power, as it is buggy and it doesn't work as intended. Anyways, we just have over 7 miles to go as we get closer to Cardiff Central, as we are going to be going through the Down Main, as we will be going through the centre tracks and not through any of the platforms. As you can see on the display below on the screen, we are coming up to a reduced speed of 40 miles per hour as we get closer towards Cardiff Central. So I'm just going to idle the power and come down smoothly. And we just got an AWS warning there of the reduced speed limit coming up to us now. As expected, folks, we are being overtaken by a GWR HST that is being led by 43185 that was in the special intercity livery. Depending on the time we reach Cardiff Central, we may have to wait for a train to depart the station, or we may get the road, but that'll determine how the signaler at the Cardiff Central determines the AI routes. Honestly, folks, this is not me doing the par. This is the bugged, well slept script that come with this train. If anyone knows how to fix this issue, I would appreciate any links to a patch or something, as this Class 60 should not be jolting forwards and backwards like this. But to be honest, folks, and to be fair to this train, this is quite an old add-on. So, hopefully once Bossman Games releases their version of the Class 60, of which I'm looking forward to getting, once it is publicly available, I will be using that in many of my scenarios. And hopefully, fingers crossed, it won't have the bugged, well slipped like this older Just Trains add-on does. Okay then, folks. We do have another caution signal, so we will have to wait until another passenger train has cleared the line, and then we can proceed onwards to our next checkpoint. As you can see there, folks, we now have a clear signal, a caution, and just a wee trick there. If you don't want to stop at this signal, just drive very slowly as you get closer to Cardiff. As you know, we are routed to go through the central tracks in between platforms 3 and 4. I believe so. Or it could be platforms 2 and 3. I'm not entirely sure about looking at the map, to be honest, folks. But we are going through the central tracks now as we continue on towards Markham, of which will be the final stop for this train. Anyways, just a wee question for you folks. So far, what's your opinion on this scenario? Will this be the kind of scenario you'd like to play? Or would you prefer something a bit easier? Please do let me know in the comment section below of what you think to this work in progress scenario that I'm creating. as you may have read there, folks, a local passenger train at Meskin has failed in service, so we are clear to use the through roads. So we will not be going through any more passing loops between here and Margam. So, as you can tell, it's quite an intensive scenario, folks, and I'm using all the power available to me. I'm using full power, although it is displaying 84%, as we are going slightly uphill as we're passing. Not entirely sure why I've been routed onto this slow line, as I should have been on the one to the right hand side there, folks, but I will look into this and it will be fixed before this scenario is released to the public, okay? So don't be worrying about that. I can assure you that when you download this scenario, it will be fully working and it will be fully functional, as I do quality and I test my stuff really well. And as you can see here, folks, this is just very much a work in progress, and I will fix that once I go back into the scenario editor, just so that I'm using the correct tracks and stuff, okay? As you can see there, folks, this train is just having a random kangaroo moment again. But there's nothing I can do about it. And I'm not even touching the power. So I'm just going to leave it where it is. Hopefully it will sort itself out. this is the furthest I've been, folks, in this part of the scenario. As you can see, we are losing speed quite rapidly. I'm not sure how far we have to go up this steep hill, but the torque on this Class 60, to be honest, when compared to the real ones, is absolutely disgusting. And I may have to have a look at the setup just to see if I can increase the horsepower, as this shouldn't be happening with a Class 60, and I shouldn't need to double head with another Class 60 or a 66 just to pull this kind of train up a hill. Some of the other UK parts of the routes, this hill is not that steep. Although thankfully, we are reaching the top of the hill according to this display at the bottom of the screen, and we are picking up speed again. I was getting concerned that the train was going to stall and then go backwards. Although thankfully, I have been able to acknowledge the vigilance system in good time, like so. As the last thing I want to happen is for the brakes to come on when I'm going up that very steep hill. But to be honest, this Just Trains Class 60 does seem rather weak when compared to the rail locomotives. So I'm not sure if the tuning is actually accurate for this locomotive. But I will have a look anyways. And if so, I will increase the power to match the real things. As to be honest with you folks, the horsepower of a real Class 60 should be 3150. As where, to be honest, the one on this game does seem to feel rather weak and underpowered. The good news is, folks, we are picking up speed again, and we're just under 5.5 miles to go before we pass through Bridge End, Platform 1. We now have just 4 miles to go before we go through bridge end. And as you can see here, folks, we do have some very slippery rails, even though we are going downhill and we are picking up speed. This Class 60 decides to go into kangaroo mode again. That's quite comical. It does get a bit annoying after a while. So I'll have to see if I can make a patch for this, just to remove some of the bugs, or if there's a patch available, just to stop this kangaroo momentum that this train does at random, as it is very random it does this. Anyways, we're coming up to our maximum speed for this service of 60 miles per hour. But we are going to be going uphill again, so I'm just going to keep going, as the last thing I want to happen is for this train to be stranded on a hill. But we are getting closer to bridge end anyways. As you can see there, folks, I'm just coming up to our new lower speed limit of 60 miles an hour. This is technically the maximum permitted speed for this oil train, as we're getting closer to bridge end, at which I will do a warning horn as we pass through bridge end on our way towards Morgan. I do hope you are enjoying this let's play, folks, as I'm certainly am enjoying this too. Anyways, just coming through bridge end now, so I'm just going to sound the horn just to warn passengers to keep back whilst we pass through this station at speed. And as you can see on the right there, through the ring, we have just passed a class 150-2 that would be in place of a class 143 pacer. But anyways, we now have just under 10 miles to go before we reach our final point for this let's play, and that will be Margam Abbey West Down Line. Anyways, the maximum speed for our train is still 60 miles an hour, so We have a reduced speed limit of 75 miles an hour coming up, of which will not really affect this train, as the maximum we can do is 60 miles per hour. I just acknowledged the AWS there before it went off, as the WASP striped box did illuminate on the HUD. So I just acknowledged that quickly before the alarm went off. So that was good timing on my part. Anyways, continuing on our journey towards our final stop for this service. And I do hope you are enjoying this Let's Play, folks. It is a long one, as this is one of my harder scenarios. But it's nice to do something different anyways, don't you think? Right, folks, we do have about 3 miles to go before we reach our home target, of which we'll conclude this Let's Play. I do hope you have enjoyed this one. It is nice to do something different compared to the usual simple A to B passenger services. But anyways, I believe we are coming up to a 20 mile an hour speed limit, so I'm going to get ready to slow down as we're not too far away from Bargain and we have a massive yard to go through. So I'm just going to start slowing down now. As you know, this train takes a long time to come to a complete stop, and we are going downhill as well, so just to keep that in mind when you play this scenario for yourselves, folks. Okay, I will fix all the pathing issues, such as the one at Cardiff Canton, as it shouldn't have gone on the slow line. It should have stayed on the middle tracks, but I will fix that before this scenario is released, okay? Right, folks, we're just arriving into Margam and we're not too far away from our checkpoint here, folks. I just want to say to yous, if you made it this far into the video, a big thank you for watching, and I do hope you have enjoyed this somewhat different Let's Play of my upcoming scenario for the South Wales Mainline route, also known as the South Wales Coastal as well. Like and your comments and stuff, okay? And I do welcome your suggestions and any requests you may want to see. If I own the trains and rolling stock, I will try and fulfill your requests for scenarios and stuff. But anyways, this is all for now, folks. I do wish all of you a great week or weekend whenever you are watching this video, okay? But until next time, folks, take care of yourselves, look after yourselves and each other. All the best and God bless. Cheerio, folks, and I will catch yous in another video coming soon, okay?